Hey guys, what's up? It's Hashir Tehami with another tutorial on the auto layout. And this time, as we have already covered the basics of auto layout in the previous two videos that were pretty short ones, and we weren't actually working with actual use cases of the auto layout. So this time I've grabbed this screenshot from Google. It's a basic UI that we can use to replicate or start our design from scratch using auto layout, so we can have a better understanding on how things connect and how we should begin with. So first of all, if you are looking for designing something like this, then you have to like observe the design and divide the whole screen into different components. Now, as you can see in this screenshot, we've got this at the top, which we can call top bar, anything you want. Then we have this table right here, the pagination at the bottom, and then we've got this chart and this another component that is going to be a separate auto layout frame. First, we are going to start with the top bar. Now, as you can see that we have a lot of components here and there. We've got logo, then we have three buttons, the search in input field, and then two more input fields, and then the profile drop down. So let's begin. First of all, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a copy and crop this one out so we can only look into this one. Grab a frame for a MacBook Pro 14. Okay, that's huge. We're gonna make it wide enough so we can see what we are doing, and yeah, we've got the desktop. Now, starting with the top bar, we need icons. So what I'm gonna do is grab some icons from the Font Awesome library. Give me a sec. One more thing, if you are thinking what I'm doing right now, I'm just using the Font Awesome library, where you can type in the codes for the icons, and the Font Awesome library would render them onto your Figma board itself. So I can make a different a separate tutorial for that later, but right now the it is different. All right, so it's done. Now we need to have these icons with a text, right? Okay, so in this specific video, I'm not covering the components and their variants. It should be all these buttons should be a component and a variant, so you can like select the different options. Like this one is the activated mode of this button, and these are the default view. So there should be the better way would be to have a component and their variant set first, and then use them here, as we are going to repeat those components. But right now it's just an auto layout demonstration, so I'm gonna take you down with the auto layout system first, and then we will look into the component and their variants later. Now we need text, so I'm gonna change the font for this one. All right. Actually take them later. Now you all know how to create an auto layout frame. I'm gonna select these two and press Shift A, and it's now into an auto layout frame. I'm gonna give it a fill color that is going to be the same as we have in the screenshot. Now for the padding, I'm gonna set horizontal padding 16 pixels and the vertical 124, just to have a similar thing that we have in the screenshot. And again, for the font, I'm going to use bold for activated and default medium for default. And yeah, that would be it for the first button. Now for the second button, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate this one. How I did that was I kept pressing Alt button and just dragged the whole frame. Now one thing that a lot of people do is they select not the whole frame, they select the single button, and when you do that, you are actually selecting an element inside that frame. You don't want to do that. You have to select the whole frame to duplicate it. So I'm selecting the frame, press Alt and duplicate that frame. Quite easy peasy. Okay, now I want these two into have an actually let's just create buttons right now. Fill this one with this color, and again duplicate this one with this color. Alright, so this has a different text, medium. This one has portfolio alert, and I'm gonna copy the styles. How do we do that? We press Control Alt C, Command Alt C for Mac, and then select the text, the other one that we want to replicate the styles from the other one, and press Control Alt V. Easy peasy. Now I want these icons to be replaced with these, so I'm gonna press Control X and select the icon itself and Control Shift R. What that does is it replaces the selected, or you know, the copied item that you have in your clipboard, and replaces it with the selected item. So again, I'm gonna replace this icon with this one, so Control X for cut, and then select the icon I want to remove, and then Control Shift R. Easy. Then next we have a search input box. Again, I want a search icon and a text. Easy. And then select these two, Shift A. Again, I want 8 padding between these two items, and again for these buttons that we had created, we have 12 pixels, which is fine, I think. So I'm gonna keep it that way. For this particular frame, I'm gonna change the color and change the padding to maybe 16 pixels, and 16 would be fine, I think. Then it has a border radius of 4, I think. Easy. Okay, it doesn't have that much padding, so I'm gonna call it 8 pixels and change the width myself to to replicate this one, and it's done. Okay, not done completely. I'm gonna change the font color, and yeah, it's done. Then we have another text, from and to fields, 12/16/2018. Again, Shift A. Oh, sorry, Shift A for auto layout. Fill the color, give it a border radius, and okay, it has different padding, so I'm gonna take it 32. Once that's done, we need another one of these. The padding is slightly different, so I'm gonna have it 24 pixels, I think that's fine. And again, replicate this text. Okay, this text size is different, so let's give it a 14 pixel. It's just a tutorial. It's we are not handling the font sizes right now. Is just a basic tutorial for auto layout. Okay, so again these two fields are repeated, so I'm gonna duplicate these two and call it 2 and give it a different date, which should be 31, and it's done. Okay, not all done. Then we have the profile drop down. Okay, so we need a down arrow from Font Awesome again. Oops. Oh. Okay. Alright, this is not the icon we need. I'm not gonna go into the library and search myself. I'm just gonna create one. And the name, of course, and we need a picture now, and that's where he comes in. I'm gonna mask it into the circle that I just created, and then resize the image. Awesome. Now, why didn't I use the image itself and put the radius around it and circled it around? The reason behind that is if you do that, we don't really have that much that much freedom to change the images inside a frame, because we have we are using the image itself as a frame. So I don't do that. It's a better practice. I don't know if it is, but for me it is better, because now I have the full authority over the frame itself and I can change the image whenever I want. So yeah, that these are the components that we needed, and I think it's done. Now the final part, we have to identify how these components are, you know, fit in together. So if you look at this one, it's jumbled up right now, but still you can differentiate between three sections, or four sections actually. So first section would be the logo and the three tabs, then the search bar, then there would be these four fields, and then the profile drop down. So I'm starting with this one. I'm gonna press Shift A to make this specific drop down a frame and put whatever padding I want. I'm gonna put 8 pixels. Now there is this one, so I'm gonna select these four and press Shift A to make an auto layout component, give it a 8 pixels spacing, and done. Then I'm gonna leave this one for now, because it's not connected with either of both the sections that are on either side of them, this one. And then select these three actually, Shift A. They shouldn't have any, you know, padding between them, so I'm gonna call 0. Then this one, of course, I'm gonna just make a frame, and I'm just resizing it, you know, just to make sure that we don't mess up, and put the logo in the center, and that's it, we're done. Now this frame and this frame should be together with 0 pixels in between. Yep, it's all done. Now the final part is to how we have to like arrange these four you know, sets of auto layouts. So I'm gonna select all of them, press Shift A, and yep, lovely. It's all done, although I can see that this one doesn't have any padding on the right side. So I'm going to select this and put a padding of 16 pixels, maybe left and right. And yeah, it's done. Now, as you can see, right now, when we created the frame with all these four sets of auto layout frames, the Figma itself put the 65 spacing between them automatically, because that was the closest number that Figma could found. But I don't want 65 pixels between them. I want this to be automated. So I'm gonna put auto, and now the whole frame can be adjusted by me, which is pretty awesome. So I'm gonna fit it within the screen, and now I have the full authority to, you know, change the size of the search field. And we are all done. It's perfect. I don't know if the color is the same, but yeah, let's change the color of the background for now so we can differentiate the top bar with the bottom area. But yeah, that's done. So in the next video, I'm gonna walk you through with how to make this table and auto layout. But for this video, that's all, guys. So please subscribe to the channel and like the video. And yeah, take care.